Hello everyone. So moving forward, so we'll see our next theory. If you have missed the other theories, you can see in the link given below. So we are going to cover the every theory. See, my approach here is, again, see, it won't be possible for me to explain each and everything, okay? Because to cover each theory, it takes a lot of time and efforts, okay? But I want to give you some rough idea so that whatever things, which things you have to cover from the theories, okay, that is my approach. कि आपको कौन सी चीजें cover करनी है theory से, आपको थोड़ा बहुत ये तो understanding आ जाएगा. तो हम structure देंगे, देखेंगे अच्छे से, तो आपको पता लग जाएगा कि हाँ, मुझे ये theory करनी है और मैं जब ये theory पढ़ूंगा तो ये theory में ये सारी बातें आनी चाहिए. ये जो ये approach मेरा रहेगा, okay? So जो पीपल फॉर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर 2020-2021, तो उनके लिए बहुत ज्यादा हेल्पफुल रहेगा. ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द कॉग्निटिव एंथ्रोपोलॉजी. कॉग्निटिव एंथ्रोपोलॉजी स्टडी करेंगे. कॉग्निटिव एंथ्रोपोलॉजी में फर्स्ट इज इंट्रोडक्शन. इंट्रोडक्शन इज द स्टडी ऑफ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन ह्यूमन सोसाइटी. इट इज द स्टडी ऑफ रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द ह्यूमन सोसाइटी human society and human thought. Okay, it is the study of relationship between human society and human thought, as said by Andrade. Okay, ये human society जो है, okay, ये human thought से हम इसको कैसे percept करते हैं, perception कैसे किया जाएगा. Okay, so there are two things, one is perception, other is cognition. Okay, तो हम ये human society को कैसे percept करेंगे. And cognition is attributing the meaning to it. Cognition is attributing the meaning to it. Okay, so ये है cognitive theory. In the cognitive theory, ये cognitive theory आई कहाँ से? First कि ये cognitive theory का start कहाँ से होता है? Okay, now people were studying theories. Classical evolutionism was there, functionalism is there. Okay, सारी theories आई. उसके बाद few people thought, like Edward Safir, Benjamin Moore, then Trubetskoy is there. Okay, these people thought that people are studying culture from a very you know the concept of emic and etic. So etic perspective, and they are not giving the importance to the cultural ideas of that culture. वो जो कल्चर है उसके कल्चरल आइडियाज को एक इंपॉर्टेंस दिया नहीं जा रहा है. ओके, सो दे थॉट दैट. सो आफ्टर थिंकिंग दैट दे केम विद द आइडिया ऑफ न्यू एथनो साइंस. दे केम विद द आइडिया ऑफ न्यू एथनो साइंस. ओके, और न्यू एथनोग्राफी यू कैन टॉक अबाउट. ओके, सो अंडर दैट दे सेड दैट, अंडर दैट दे सेड दैट, To study any culture, we need to give importance to their own thought, their own ideas. कि उनका क्या मतलब, what they want to study. We give importance to that, and we give more importance to the emic perspective. That is the perspective of the people of that culture. Perspective of the people of that culture. That is emic perspective. So this, you know the concept of Edward Sapir and Benjamin Wolf hypothesis. That is Sapir-Whorf hypothesis. This is important. Sapir-Whorf hypothesis, they can ask. Sapir-Whorf hypothesis, they talk about new ethnography. And this is Sapir-Whorf hypothesis. They say that if language is influenced by any culture, so in return, vice versa is also true. That is, culture is influenced by language. Culture is influenced by language. They give two concepts, that is linguistic relativity and linguistic determinism. You can read about Sapir-Whorf hypothesis. Okay. So coming to the basic premises of cognitive theory, these anthropologists say that there are universal cognitive processes which talks about these universal cognitive processes. They talk about that how the innate structure of human mind is there. Okay, brain का जो एक innate structure होता है, how is it? Okay, so they explain the innate structure of human brain. So they explain the innate structure of human brain. Okay, then जब हम इमिक पर्सपेक्टिव की बात करते हैं, व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द इमिक पर्सपेक्टिव, सो हियर हियर व्हाट दिस कॉग्निटिव एंथ्रोपोलॉजिस्ट से दैट दिस दे स्टडी हाउ पीपल अंडरस्टैंड एंड ऑर्गेनाइज कल्चरल ऑब्जेक्ट्स इवेंट्स realities around them and how do they perceive that, how do they understand and organize. Okay, let's say talking from Indian example, one tribe is there which is there in the northeast. Okay, so they must be having some different concepts. Okay, now आपको अगर पता है दैट फॉर डिफरेंट फ्रूट्स देर आर डिफरेंट नेम्स इन एवरी कल्चर, फॉर डिफरेंट वेजिटेबल्स देर आर डिफरेंट नेम्स. ओके, सो व्हाई इज इट देयर, ये क्यों है? बिकॉज एवरी कल्चर, वो कल्चर के पीपल जो है, द पीपल ऑफ दैट कल्चर, दे अंडरस्टैंड एंड ऑर्गेनाइज दिस कल्चरल ऑब्जेक्ट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू देम. ओके, सो यहां पे this cognitive anthropologist said that we don't have any right to our own culture, we don't have to any right to impose our own cultural ideas, our own cultural ideas on any society, our own cultural ideas on any kind of society. Okay, so then they say how do they see the world around them, because to see the world around them, they must be having their own cultural thought. Okay, they study this according to their own cultural thought. Okay, so these are the basic premises of cognitive theory. Then what is methodology to study this cognitive theory? What is the methodology? This universal cognitive process which we have talked, the structure of human brain, the mind, it is studied by linguistic analysis. And here comes the Sapir-Whorf hypothesis comes into picture here. This linguistic analysis, they have explained the linguistic analysis. Okay, so Sapir-Whorf hypothesis talks about that to understand human thought and culture, we need linguistic analysis. Even E.B. Tyler has said that. Okay, E.B. Tyler also has said that. Okay, so they use this method. So two main thinkers are there. One is Harold Conkling and another is Stephen Tyler. So what is the study of Harold Conkling? Harold Conkling has studied the Hanno color categories. He has studied the Hanno color categories in Philippines. Okay, so Hanno color categories. Now these Hanno people, they have different meanings, different division of these colors. Now when they say that Mahavir, that is darkness, now this darkness is reflected by sufficiency. So darkness mein, now for green, they have Mahavir. Mahalakshmi is lightness, so scarcity principle. Lightness means red. And same is Mahavara and Mahalakshmi. Okay, greenness and dry also. Okay, so these color categories of Hanno people, they are according to their own cognitive process. This is how they perceive the materialistic world. So, यहाँ पे cognitive theory is not about material world, it is about how you perceive the material world. Okay, now Stephen Tyler has said that there are various semantic domains jo hum kya karte hain ki whatever we know we try to compartmentalize it. Okay, so Stephen Tyler his name of the book is Cognitive Anthropology. Okay, cognitive anthropology is the name of the book. So Stephen Tyler talked about Koya people. Okay, so he has said that this Koya people, now we like there are different name of ice is there, then snow is there, snowflake is there, then okay, there are different names. Now these Koya people, they don't differentiate in this. They don't differentiate in this because they find everything is same, but they differentiate into seven types of bamboo. Because bamboo is their material culture, and this is how their cognitive process organize that material principle. Okay, so this is how they study this cognitive anthropology study. So what is the significance of it? ये इसका significance क्या है? Cognitive anthropology का significance क्या है? One significance is they give importance to the cultural criteria of the native people. That is emic thought. They give importance to the emic thought. Okay, significance ये कि they give importance to the emic thought. They talk about cultural relativity. They talk about cultural relativity, and this cognitive anthropology, cognitive theory, can we use this theory to understand the culture of the tribals, right? Tribals का culture हम study कर सकते हैं, because tribals have their own cultural criteria, right? So ये उसका significance है, लेकिन इसका criticism ये है, they cannot study the non-verbal behavior. Non-verbal behavior वो study नहीं कर सकते, because this is all depend on the linguistic analysis. Okay, so cognitive anthropology again very interesting theory, again many implications. So we have studied the cognitive anthropology. Thank you.